10 minutes. So he's the one I'm working with. So child of God, the scripture tells us that a lot of people are deceived and they like to mock God. And you know that people are deceived when they're on their job and they like to do whatever they want to do. They come to work whenever they want to. They come late, they want to go to lunch early, and come back late. They want to go home early. When they come to work late, they use excuses like the alarm clock didn't go off. I overslept. I got caught by the train. And also nowadays, people are mocking the Lord. They don't believe what he said. It's like they're turning their nose up at God. That's what it said when you mock him, you are turning your nose up at the Lord. And we know as kids growing up, when we talk back to our parents, we got smacked for that. So, you know, when you mock God, you will reap what you sow. You know, it may not now, but you will reap what you sow. And you can stop some of their reaping by repenting and turning around. And I'd like to tell you, there are both positive and negative results in sowing. Blessed family, I submit to you that all we do is sow, that we reap what we sow, but we sow more than we reap.
Yeah.
When a farmer plants a kernel of corn, it produces a stalk, not just one ear. May I tell you that if you sow a little, you will reap a little. If you sow a lot, you will reap a lot. And if you sow nothing, you will reap nothing. If you do not sow seeds, you should not expect a harvest from God. And that reminds me of a little nursery rhyme when I was a kid about a little red hen. Be bear with me for a minute. Put my glasses on. Okay, in the tale, the little red hen finds a grain of wheat and asks for help from the other farmyard animals. She asks a pig, she asks a duck, and a dog to plant it, but they all refused. At each stage, harvest, threshing, milling the wheat into flour, and baking the flour into bread, the hen again asks for help from the other animals, but again, she does not receive any help. Finally, the hen has completed her task and asks, who will help her to eat the bread? This time, all the previous non-participants eagerly volunteer, but she disagreed with them, stating that no one helped her with the work.
That's right.
Thus, her hands and her eat the food all by themselves.
Yes.
And that reminds me, in 2 Thessalonians, it says, if any do not work, neither should they eat. So the hand had it right. Why should you eat if you didn't help? Do you know, child of God, many Christians want a great harvest from God, but they do not plant any seeds. Do you not know your harvest depends on what you sow? If you sow peaches, don't expect watermelons. If you sow plums, don't expect pears. If you sow hate, don't expect love in return. But 2 Corinthians 9:6 says, he which soweth sparingly shall reap sparingly. That means if you sow just a little, if you sow just small amounts, that's what you're going to get. And he was so advised.